In section 3.5, as we start to learn more about our different sorts of figures, we're going to add some more tools that we can use. And those tools are using parallel lines and also triangles for measures. So there's a little problem at the start that's asking you basically for a proof of how we know a triangle will have a certain sum of all three angles. And I wrote the solution to that proof off to the right. So this would be an example, and we'll look at what that sort of example is going to mean. If I rearrange those three angles of a triangle, I could arrange them in a certain order so that they all add up to form a straight line. And that should show us something about what we know for the measure of all three of a triangle's angles. First, though, before we deal with triangles, we're talking about parallel lines. So our parallel postulate says that through any point not on a line, there's one and only one line that I can draw parallel to the given line. So if I just start with one point P and it's not on line L, there's exactly one line that I can draw through P that goes parallel to L. So again, any arrangement that I can make that's slightly different, so if I had that at a slightly different slope, going down, or if it's going up a little bit different slope, that's eventually going to pass through line L. So if I start with a point, only one line that I can draw parallel to the one that I start with, and that's the one that I have marked right there. Also, a lot of you guys might have seen this rule before, but the sum of the measures of the angles in a triangle are always going to be the same, and we kind of proved that up at the very top with that question. And the sum of the measures of a triangle is always going to be 180. So a lot of you guys have seen that if I add all three angles, so in this case A and B and C, if I add all three of those angles up, I should always get 180 if I'm dealing with a triangle. So when I know the measures of two angles in a triangle, we should always use the triangle sum theorem if we want to find the measure of the third angle, because again, that would mean there's only one variable missing. So an example of that would be problem one here, and we see that actually with two different triangles, well, three triangles if I look at the combined figure as a bigger triangle. So I can use just our triangle theorem to find the measures of x, y, and z. Again, just the fact that the angles in a triangle should be 180. First, if I'm looking for x, I can see this triangle ABD off to the left-hand side. I have a 59 and a 43 degree angle given. X is the last angle missing in that triangle, so I can make this first equation. 43 plus 59 plus x, those three measures of that left-hand triangle, those should add up to 180. So combine like terms and subtract to solve for x, we get that that missing measure is 78 degrees, so that would be x in that bottom right corner for angle BDA. So if I want to find y, something that we could use is the fact that I still have a linear pair. X and y combine to form this straight line for AC. So if I take x plus y, that should just be 180. Again, linear pair is always supplementary. And since we already know that x is 78, all I have to do is subtract and find that y is 102 degrees. And using the answer for y, we can then use that to find z. Because if I look at this right-hand triangle, BDC, it looks like if I take 49 plus y plus z, I'll have the three measures in that triangle also. So making that equation, again, 49 plus y plus z, all those angles are in the same triangle, so that should add up to 180. Since we know that y is 102 from our work, we can plug that in, combine like terms, and then solve to find that z is just going to be 29 degrees. It's actually another way we can find z without using angle y. If I look to the bigger triangle, 59 plus 43 plus 49 plus z, those three angles make up the entire triangle for ABC. So there's a way to find z without needing to find y, but since we already found y, that might make that a little bit easier. Just look at those three angles missing the triangle. So again, big rule there, if I add up three angles in a triangle, I should always get 180 for that interior sum. And notice I said interior sum because we have such a thing as an exterior angle of a polygon, or in this case, a triangle. And that's any angle that I form by taking a side and an extension of an adjacent side. So we see that in these three examples. Again, that's like taking side that matches with, or I guess not matches, but it's next to angle 3 there. If I take this side and extend the other side, exterior angle is angle 1. Same thing, I have a side and the extension of a side, and side and extension of a side. So for each exterior angle of the triangle, there's also two non-adjacent interior angles, and we call those the remote interior angles. So what I mean by that, again, if I have angle 1 is the exterior angle in all these figures, angle 2 and angle 3 are what we call the remote interior. So you just think that remote should mean it's farther away from that exterior angle. If I have angle 1, angle 2 and angle 3 should not be adjacent, so it's not the one that's right next to it. But on the other parts of that triangle, angle 2, angle 3, those are still in the interior, so we still call those interior angles. So again, exterior angle, two remote interiors, exterior angle, two remote interiors. So we can use these angles to come up with another fact about the angles in a triangle. The measure of each exterior angle of a triangle is equal to the sum of the two remote interior angles. So like those examples that we saw up above, if one is the exterior angle, it's going to be the same thing as adding angle 2 and angle 3 together. So that's another quick way we can get angle measures without having to find that last missing angle of the triangle. So for example, in problem 2, if I'm looking to find the measure of angle 1, angle 1 is an exterior angle, so all I have to do is say that the measure of angle 1 is going to be the same as adding 80 plus 18 together. So all I have to do is add those and get 98. That's going to be my exterior angle. We could also use the same theorem, but rather than finding the exterior angle, I could also use it to find one of the two remote interiors. And again, here's I'm given what I was trying to find before. I'm given the measure of the exterior angle, and I can use that with the same formula to find the measure of that missing interior angle. I want to make sure that angle 2 is not equal to the sum of the ones that I'm given. Remember, since angle 2 is an interior angle, that's going to be part of the sum that makes that total of 124 for the exterior. So again, exterior angle, 124, is equal to the sum of the two remote interiors, that's 59, plus the one that I'm trying to find for angle 2. All I have to do here is subtract, so 124 subtract the first angle that I'm given, and I find the other remote interior, that would be 65 degrees. So problem 3, we also see that in sort of a word problem. We have a radar receiver at point A, we have an airplane at point B, and we also have a ghost, or I guess just the shadow reflection, at D. So we want to use that to find the value of x. That would be the angle formed by, it looks like, the plane, the tower, and that shadow. So it looks like I'm given 80 degrees as an exterior angle. Again, I know it's exterior because that's formed by the extension of that side and the side of the triangle that's next to it. So if 80 degrees is the exterior angle, again, that should be the sum of the two remote interiors. And those that we're given are 30, and the one we're trying to find are x. So just like that problem 2 up above, I guess part B, I know that the exterior angle is 80. So if I take 30 plus x, the two remote interiors, that should be equal to that same sum. All I got to do is subtract 30 and find that that missing angle is 50. So again, if I check my answer, 50 plus 30, those two remote interiors add up to 80, which is our exterior. So that works according to our formula. One more question at the bottom. This actually is not using exterior angles, but like what we saw from the first part, if I add the three angles in a triangle, I should always get 180. So the only equation we have to make here is 2x plus 4 plus this expression, 2x minus 9. Add x to that. If I add all three angles of that triangle, again, sum should always be 180. So just a few algebra steps, combine like terms, add 5 to both sides, then divide by 5. We should get that x is 37. So really a couple things to watch out here is blah, blah, blah.